Hello friends, welcome to SlideHunt with the video tutorial on C++ programming. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you about the public and private access specifier. Here we learn how to create and use public and private variables. First, we talk about the public access specifier. For that, I'm going to create here a class. In our previous tutorial, we discussed about the classes and objects. So I'm not going to details about it. To create a class, first we have to write the keyword class and then class name, let's say student, and then a pair of curly braces, and the class definition is terminated by a semicolon. Inside the class, we need to specify the access specifier. Here I'm going to write public, then colon. Public indicates that the variables or functions that we declare or define here can be accessed from inside the class as well as from outside the class also. Here I am going to create an integer type variable, int roll number. Next I am going to create here a function, void display. Then a pair of parentheses. Since the function display is not going to take any parameter, so leave it blank. The function display will print the value of roll number. So I'm going to write here cout. My roll number is, and here we refer roll number. And then end of line. The next thing that we need to do, declare an object of class student. So I'm going to write here student and then object name, let's say David. Next we assign some values to the variable roll number. For that I'm going to write here David dot and then variable name, that is roll number. And then assign some values. I'm going to write here 5. Next we call the function display. So I'm going to write here David dot display. Let's check the output, build and run. As you can see here, it print my roll number is 5. Okay, next we talk about the private access specifier. To declare private member, first we have to write the keyword private, then colon. The class member that we have been declared as private cannot be accessed from outside the class. I am going to declare here an integer type variable, int marks. If we try to access this variable from main function, it will give some error. I'm going to write here David dot marks equal to 87. Let's check the output, build and run. As you can see here, it gives an error, in student marks is private. We cannot access private member outside the class. Only the member functions that are declared within the class can access the private member or variables. To access the private member, I am going to write here another function, void getData, and we are going to get a value. So I am going to write here int number, and I am going to save this number to the variable marks, that is marks equal to number. And inside the display function, I am going to write here cout. My marks is, and here we refer marks, and then end of line. The next thing that we need to do, call this function getData from main and pass a value to this function. So I am going to delete this statement, and here I am going to write David dot function name, that is getData. and within the parenthesis I'm going to pass a value, suppose 87. Let's check the output, build and run. As you can see here, it print my roll number is 5 and then my marks is 87. So what we learn here, we can access a public member directly using a dot operator, but we can't access a private member directly. We can access the private member using a member function which is declared inside the class where the private member is also declared. The next thing is, what is the uses of private variables? If we don't want to access the member outside the class, then we declared it as private. For this case, we don't want to access the variable marks outside the class. For that, we declared marks as private. The last thing that I want to tell you, the uses of the keyword private is optional. If we don't use this keyword here, though the variable marks will be considered as a private member, because by default the member of a class are private. I am going to delete it and now check the output, build and run. As you can see here, for this case we also get the same output. That's it, hope you understand. If you have any doubt, please comment on the video, and if you have any suggestion, please tell us. Thanks for watching. To watch more videos, please subscribe this channel SlideHunt. You can like my Facebook page at www.facebook.com/slidehunt, and you can follow me on Google Plus at www.google.com/plus/slidehunt.